Hi everyone, hope you all are doing really well and happy Holi guys, as I am recording this video on Holi festival. So happy Holi to all of you. So yeah, celebrate and stay safe, stay at home and take all the necessary precautions as we all know, and you can invest your time again on learning. So this, as I'm preparing videos on, I'm making videos on banking domains, I think this topic is a very important topic, which is payment gateway for banking domain. So I think Infosys and many of the organizations are hiring for this thing, and there was one of the person who has asked me for this, and I've shared this slide with that person, and he's able to, you know, answer all the questions related to payment gateway. So how you can, you know, explain your project regarding payment gateway for banking domain, and there are interview questions which is based on this, like payment gateway, and I think that person I was able to answer, and I think he has qualified too. So let's move on to the video, and this video has all the interview questions related to testing, like when you go for a testing interview. So this video has all the questions about that also. So let's move into the next slide, first slide. So what is payment gateway? So payment gateways are softwares and server that transmit transactions information to acquiring banks, and response from issuing banks, such as whether a transaction is approved or declined. Payment gateway usually charge those who use them as per transaction fees. So we everywhere we use payment gateway method, right? So that plays a very important role, and in our day-to-day life, because now everything is digitalized and we use payment, like we use many times digital payments instead of, you know, hard cash. So that payment gateways are very important, and there are different terms we used it as an acquiring bank, and there are many other things like merchants and many things we used it. So in this video we covered all those things. So I request you to, you know, see all the slides, which will help you in your interview if you are not that much aware of payment domain. Yeah. So payment gateway is a technology that captures and transfer payment data from customer to the acquirer. A payment gateway is what keeps the payment ecosystem rolling smoothly, as it enables online payments for customers and business. So as we all know, right, it will give you know, it offer all the online payments, we use payment gateways. So it will be useful for consumers and business, and you know, because of the payment gateway we have all the things very convenient, and our ecosystem is running very smoothly because of the payment gateway. So what is merchant account? So in that we use always merchant accounts. A merchant account is a specific bank account acquired for card payments, online trading, not to be confused with a business bank account through payment gateways. Okay, so what is merchant account? They will be asking you the questions on that. So you have to understand, payment service providers, PSP, acquire payment processor, independent sales organization or high street bank can provide you with a merchant account. Once your application for a merchant account is approved, you will assign as a merchant identification number, MID, as an account number for your merchant account. It is required to process the card transactions and move funds from customer issuing banks to your business account, right? When you might have seen that people have their machines with their cards, so they have their merchant account with that, and they have their own MIDs, and with that there's a process involved in it. Once their payments are authorized and ready to be settled by your acquire, so that's how that process is. Like if you get the machine, so what are the process you have to do that? So those are the things we need. Okay. Okay. So when a customer clicks on the pay button on your website, so these are the process involved in the process. So what are the process? Like when you click, or like that will be the question. When you click on the pay button, what are the process that happens? Because you are the users, you don't know what is happening in the back end. So merchant, this is you, is an online business operating in a vertical, travel, retail, e-commerce, gaming, forex, etc., offering a product or service to a customer. The customer also called cardholder who want to access the product or service that the merchant is selling and initiate the transaction. The issuing bank is the customer's banks that issue the cardholders a credit or the debit card on behalf of the card scheme, that is Visa or MasterCard. The acquirer, also known as acquiring bank, the acquirer is the financial institution that maintains the merchant bank account known as merchant's account. The acquiring bank passes the merchant's transaction to the issuing bank to receive the payment. So that's how that, you know, cycle is. When you give the payment, your bank will give the approval and then it will go to the person's bank, and after that thing, it will check the accounts and it will receive to the person's account. So that's how it happens. In the coming slide, you'll have the complete detail of it. So that's the slides are of around 25. So it's a quite big video and the topic is very deep detail. So if you know, if you go through with this, I think you're able to get through with the payment domain. So yeah. So this is how it is. This is what I have explained to you. So it's a bank, merchant, authorized net and gateway company, an internet web server and website customer. Okay, so that's how this process happening, and it's like interchanging process that happens here. So I'll explain you in this. I think this I'll hold on for a minute, and that's how it happens. Bank will give you the card, that is Visa or Merchant MasterCard, and it will help you for the payment gateway. Okay, with the internet web servers, you can have your you'll have your, like here what happens is, this is the one way of doing it. From here, your website customer is there, you have your own website, okay, customer website, okay. With the internet web server, you can have your payment gateway, okay. So there are two ways of having it. So front of your credit card, what happens, like maybe that will be the asking question, that what is happening in that card. So your bank branding, smart chip if it is any, and then card number, card holder's name. So these are the verifications you have to do. So what are the verifications involved while checking the card? Logo, payment network logo, expiration date, okay, back of the magnetic stripe, hologram, signature area, security code, network logo, bank contact information. So these are the validations you have to do when you're working on payment domain. What is the meaning of payment gateway? So I'll just give you the brief of it before that, and now we'll be deep diving into it. So in the simple words, the payment gateways are means to receive or make the payments. It gets a payment from your customer and settles the same to you. Okay. If you give 100 rupees from your account, it will settle like 100 rupees. Like if you have 1000 rupees, it should be 9900 from your, in your account. So it is a software that makes the transfer of the transaction data possible from the merchant to the acquiring bank. The whole payment process contains background parties which are involved to make the payment transfer possible, for which the payment gateway act as a medium to transmit the request. The main parties are issuing bank, payment processor, for example card processor, payment gateway, nodal bank and acquiring bank. So these are the main important things which is very important, which is I think this is the chart diagram of it. You can even show it in the form of box when you are explaining to the interviewer. So payment gateway first captures the customer paid amount in the nodal bank account, and then it is settled in the merchant banks as per the pre-decided settlement time period. Payment gateway even facilitate buyers and sellers protection by being a mediator between both. They have a dispute department for the same. It provides multiple payment options to your customers and allow them to pay in any way they want, like credit card, debit card, wallet, QR code, UPI, Bheem, etc. With the help of that, the interest customer can make online payment. Those customer can make the online payment from their gadgets like computer, laptop, smartphone, etc. from anywhere in the world, vanishing the borders and distance. Right. So with that, I think as we all know, we use Google Pay, we use Phone Pay. So how we are using the apps, but the payment gateway help us to transfer our amount to the person which we wanted to transfer. So I think we are doing many things while sitting at home. So the main interface is the payment gateway, and there are many things happens in the backends, and these are it is happening, and these are the questions which has been asked in the interview, and you should know about it. The payment gateway work as a middleman between your customer and the merchant, ensuring the transaction is carried out securely and promptly. As the security is a very important thing in that, because you are putting your card details over there, and that should not be getting leaked, or it should not have some fraud and anything which should not turns out to the loss to the customer. An online payment gateway can simplify how merchants integrate this necessary software. As a middleman during the payment processing, the gateway manages the customer sensitive card details between the acquirer and the merchant. Why do we need a payment gateway? Okay, why we need it? Okay, the payment gateway is a gatekeeper of your customer's payment data for online merchants. A payment gateway relays the information from you, the merchant, to the acquirer, the issuing bank, using data encryption to keep unwanted threats away from the sensitive card data. Aside from fraud management, a payment gateway also protects the merchants from expired date, expired card, insufficient fund, closed account, or exceeding credit card limits. So payment gateway helps you in that. Okay, so that will tell you that okay, your card is expired, so you cannot make a payment at that time. Okay, so right when you are doing the payment, so those are the things which will help you. They will do the verifications of everything. So if person doesn't know the card does have money or not, okay, and that card is not having, so that payment gateway help you in all those things. It doesn't like from your account it get debited and you don't have the money in your account. So that payment gateway help you to validate all those stuffs. Okay, so how does payment gateway work? The customer chooses the product or service they want to purchase and proceed to the payment page. Most payment gateways offers you different options for your payment page. Okay, merchant's pays payment gateway offers you the below options for your payment page trailer made for you the business need. First is hosted payment page. Okay, so hosted payment page is an out of the box payment page where customers are redirected when they are ready to check out. Okay, the payment gateway securely receives the transaction data before it passes to the acquirer. Okay, a hosted payment page reduces the PCI burden for online merchant if you don't collect or the store the cardholder data on your server. Server-to-server integration. A server-to-server integration is also known as direct integration as it enables a communication between two servers. The merchant servers with the payment gateway server, by acquiring the card details on the payment page, a direct transaction can be initiated. Customer can finalize a card payment without being redirected to the payment page of the payment gateway, resulting a faster checkout, more consistent user experience, and more control on the look and feel of the payment page from the merchant's perspective. A server-to-server integration is suitable if you collect or... Okay, so these two is like... Okay, so this hosted payment page, like when you do the online payment, right? When you are ready to check out and you will go and do the transactions, whatever transactions you do, which is very secure. Server-to-server integration, when you give the card to the merchant and they'll swipe. Okay. So these are the very, I think these are very systemized and the standard form which you have to explain. You cannot, you know, mug up the concept and go and do the stuff like that. So that's how you have to prepare. So these are the very standardized and I think that we need very specific terms over there when you're giving the interview. So that's why I'm keep on reading. I'm not putting something from myself because that is not needed. Client-side encryption. So client-side encryption, also known as encryption at source, refers to encrypting sensitive data on the client side device before sending it to merchant server. This enables the merchants to simplify your PCI compliance requirement. In a nutshell, it enables you to accept the payment on your website while encrypting card data in your browser using the payment gateway encryption library. So for example, if you're sending money to someone, so it should not reveal your card details, isn't it? So it should only go to money. So those things should be, should be in the form of encrypted data. So the customer cannot be able to read it. The other person cannot. So the customer enters their credit or debit card details on the payment page. These details include the cardholder numbers, card expiration date and CVV number. This information is securely passed into your payment gateway based on your integration. That is how you did it. Hosted payment pay, server to server integration or client side. These are the way we will be, will provide the security to our customer. The payment gateway tokenizes or encrypts the card details and perform fraud checks before they send the card data to the acquiring bank. The acquiring bank sends securely the information to the card schemes. Okay, the card schemes perform another layer of fraud check and then send the payment data to the issuing bank. The issuing bank, after performing fraud screen, authorizes the transactions. The approved declined payment message is transferred back from the card schemes and then to the acquirer. So you know how it is, like very fast process, right? You'll have the transaction within a minute. So those things is like there are a couple of verification involved in those things, and that's how the process goes. So you can even explain the form of chart diagram, or the maybe you can present in the form of block diagram. So then acquiring bank sends the approval or decline message back to the payment gateway, who then transmit the message to the merchant. If the payment is approved, the acquirer collects the payment amount from the issuing bank and hold the fund into your merchant account more than later on, and deposit the fund into merchant account, a process which is known as settlement. But the actual settlement will occur depends on the agreement the merchant has with the payment gateway. Based on the message, the merchant may either display a payment confirmation message or ask the customer to provide another payment method. Okay, so that's how happen. I think these are very much known thing what we know, but if we are not from payment domain, or we wanted to go in, so these are the things which we do it, but we don't know how systematically this happens. So I think this video will give you the knowledge about that. Payment gateway versus merchant account. To accept card payments and use a payment gateway to transmit online payment data, you need to have a merchant account. Your PSP payment gateway or any other financial institute that process your payments, as previously mentioned, can issue a merchant account. Bottom line is, you can't accept online payments without having a merchant account. So this is very important. Difference between payment gateway and payment processor. There's a lot of literature available online about it, and whether the payment gateway and the payment processor are distinct module with distinct functionality. During the course of my project, I have observed that the payment processor and payment gateways are used interchangeably without any actual distinction. The merchant usually refers the payment gateway as payment processor, as these process all the payments. Okay. The payment processor consider themselves as a payment gateways, as they act as a means to process and complete the secure payment transaction. Okay, so in this project, like when I was doing the project, I mentioned that thing. So processor and payment gateways are used interchangeably, okay, without actual distinction. So merchant usually have the payment gateways as payment processor, okay. So payment gateway, they always use payment gateways as payment processor, as the process of all the payments, right, to process all the payments. And the payment processor consider themselves as a payment gateway. So both are like, right, they act as a means to process and complete the secure. Okay, I think you guys have understood. Why do we need to test payment gateways? Okay, this is a very important question as a tester. Why we need it? If you were to a shop in an actual brick or mortar store, right, we used to pay cash or swipe your card, okay, through machines during checkout to complete your transaction. If using credit or debit card, the point of sale testing machine will indicate if the payment processor would be approved or declined, right, if you give the machine to swiping machine, as we say. Similarly, during the online transaction, we need to have the comparable system in place which approves or disapproves our transaction instantly. So, from a customer perspective, the online payment processing on the e-commerce website should be seamlessly. Customer clicks pay now button and should see the payment successful or a decline message in the text next few seconds, okay? From the e-commerce store perspective, the merchant needs to ensure that the complete payment cycle, like getting transaction from online store and capture the authorized refund, voiding are working fine. If any of these subcomponents do not work as expected, then it can be the problem for the merchant. From the merchant perspective, the testing phase allows them to get used to choosing payment processor flow and evaluate if the chosen option is actually the best fit for their application business, because they will give the product, right? They have to give the product, but they should get the money off that, right? That thing what they are selling to. So kinds of testing involved in this, that you have to this thing, when you are explaining your project, you can say that I have done the functional testing, I have done this integration testing, I have done the performance testing, I have done the security testing. Functional testing is required for the newer or less established payment gateways to ensure the application behave as it should, that is, it handles the orders, calculations, taxes, etc. exactly how it's supposed to. For more established payment processor, this kind of testing may not be required, right? We do integrated testing is critical while integrating with a payment gateway. As a tester, I need to verify that the integration of our website all in store and application is working fine with the chosen payment gateway. As a tester, you need to verify the entire transaction flow. It is place order, check if funds are required in merchant account, verify if the transaction can be refunded or void successfully. Performance testing. It is essential to test the website, online store, application for the performance. The payment processor should not fail if the multiple users are trying to complete the transaction at the same time. Let's say if you are buying something from the Myntra and every, like for example, the sale time when we buy something from the Myntra, many of the people are doing transaction the multiple time when the Amazon. So they do the transaction at the same time, isn't it? So that's how it happens. So when you do the security testing, so during a transaction, a customer will be providing a sensitive information like their credit card number, CVV number, etc. So it is very important to ensure that all the sensitive information is transmitted after the encryption and that the channel is secure. So we'll move to the next slide. So what is tips? So make sure that the transaction is tested end to end. In our projects, we tested and reported numerous bugs related to data capture and data flow from application to the payment gateway. Some of the specific bugs are, what are the bugs? Like they'll be asking what kind of bugs you have found. So customer name information was not getting captured correctly. The customer credit card expiry date was not getting captured incorrectly, was getting captured incorrectly due to an incorrect function, which was causing transactions to be declined by the issuing bank on account of the incorrect credit card information. Duplicate transactions showing in the payment processor. So that's how it happens. Sometimes it happens, right? So if the payment fails a transaction for any reason, a suitable message should be shown to the customer. Any error message that is too technical, like object is not set to instant or 404 error, can cause a confuse the customer and impact the user experience. So 404 message, I think it's like everyone knows about it, and that is a bug that you should not display that. It should also a good idea to display a generic message like there seems to be some technical issues in the processing of the transaction, so please contact that following number. So that's how it happens. For the purpose of the post-production release verification, the client application business user would need to create a live payment processor account to set up their merchant ID, etc. Depending on the payment processor chosen, it may take anywhere from 2 days to a week to set up the account. This should be communicated by the project manager to the client in advance with a sufficient time to set up the live account before the application, the payment processor integrations are go live. So before that only you have to, you know, do a lot of testing in production itself. So following checklist can be helpful for the tester. And what are the things you keep in mind while doing the testing? So set up a payment processor sandbox or gather test credit card numbers that were used for the testing different credit cards. As an example, such as information for a BrainTree payment processor can be found at BrainTree payments. Verify the behavior of an application when a transaction is successful. After the successful transaction, so the payment should receive, the person should receive the message like successful message or maybe the confirmation message. Then verify that customer gets some kind of transaction confirmation notification like order confirmation, email, etc. if the transaction is successful. Check what happens if the payment fails or the payment processor stops responding. Is there any error message? Verify the application behavior with the browser pop-up blocker on off. This may be helpful if any confirmation message are being displayed in their pop-up. Verify different fraud prevention security settings. For example, if the customer billing information does not match with the address providing to the issuing bank, any mismatch will result in transaction decline. So that should happen. Okay, that is the, you know, validations you have to do. Verify the transaction entries in the database if the tester has access to the application database. So that is also the person who have the database. So while giving this thing, you should be good at database as well. So you prepare the database thing as well. Check what happens when the customer session expire message should come. Check the console during entire transaction and report any console error that are observed. Verify that the transaction is done on a secure channel. So what I said that when we do any other testing, right, when we into another domain, so every domain has a specific kind of testing. So in the banking, it has a very special type of. So in every bank you go or everything is go. So that is the must, that if you have 1 year or 2 year knowledge, that is very good. When you should have something, right? You should have some knowledge about banking. So even if you do any investment or anything, you should have some knowledge, right? blindly you cannot go. It will not give you a good result. So you, what happens is when you do investment or you consult a lot of people, you think, because it's related to money, right? So your money should not go anywhere and it should not turns out to be the loss. The loss is big. So that's the thing. So this is the, in banking, there's special kind of testing which is involved. So that's why you have to check the console and everything, because everything associated with the cost and the reputation in the bank. See. So for example, the checkout page may be HTTPS versus rest of the website that has HTTP page. Verify the payment processor currency set up correctly. For example, if the application website is in Canadian company or retailer, the payment processor should be set up to accept the CAD currency. If the application have multiple payment options like credit card and PayPal together, both payment options need to be tested individually from end to end. Verify that return or void amount from the payment processor admin portal is same as the transaction amount. In no case, the refund and void amount should be exceed the transaction amount. So I think we, as we all come for the end of this, and I think those are the checklists you have to do. Those are the, you know, I think those are the test cases and everything I have told you. I think though, if you go through with this, I think you'll be able to qualify any of the questions asked regarding the payment domain. I don't know how companies work, but there are one more question which is about flood testing, how you do that. So I think that was a question which they asked. I have not covered in my slide. I might have another videos on banking domain and I'll make it. So I'll be starting, I have around 800 questions on Java. So I'll be having, starting a series on Java. Let me know if you guys are interested. So you know, the relay you have to put yes or no into the comment section so that I'll get to know. And you can either contact me in my Facebook page if you have any queries or doubt. I can share this slide with you guys, because I think this slide is very useful for everyone. And you know, the drill, you have to put your mail IDs and I'll be sharing that slide with you. And thank you so much, and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel so that you'll get notified whenever I'll upload the video. And thank you guys, and you can even share this video to your friends who are working on banking domain, so that will give them some idea about their interviews if their interviews are coming up. Thank you.